So Kanban is nothing but a visual board basically. It's a visual task board. So where you have three columns, not started, on in progress and done. Based on the requirements, probably you can have it, the ones which is being displayed here, like under analysis, you can put ongoing, done. Maybe you are in the part of a sprint where you are in the middle of the sprint and you are also analyzing the sprint N plus one, right? So you can break down in the way you want, but the basic three fields which we have: not started, in progress, done. So the feature, there are the tasks we are working. So we have initially, to start with, we have all the tasks in the not started side. I pick feature 1 and 2, our team starts working on it. Okay, and now feature 1 and 2, the sticky note, they would be removed from not started field and they will move to in progress. They will only go, feature 1 and 2 will only move to done once the testing is complete, once the defects have been closed and there is no pending issue open against it. Till that time, it will be only in progress. Okay, it would be, so to define, to make sure that something is done, we have a something called definition of done which is created. So we follow the definition of done. So like, if from a testing perspective, if I have to quote an example from a testing perspective, my definition of a done would be, a website is would be completely tested when I have cross browser tested it across the browsers, when I have tested it across the platforms, when I have tested the backend, when I have tested the UI, or when I have tested the security. If one of the fit, if I have not done the cross-browser testing, my feature would not be complete. It would remain in a pending state. Okay? Yeah. So this is called work in progress limit. But there is a limit. Internally, when you start a project, you will have to put a work in progress limit. So for example, under in progress, there are 5 items, and in done, there are 2. So I will not pull anything from not started to in progress till I at least clear the log in progress section. I will make a hard stop at 5. We will decide on a limit at the beginning of the project that 5 is my limit. So at point where I have 5 items or tasks in my in progress section, I will make a halt, complete the in progress, move it to done, and then start the new one. This is called work in progress. And the pull thing in Kanban is pulling from non-started to not started to in progress, and then from in progress to, I'm pulling it, right? I'm not going, nothing is pushing, no, nothing is going back from done to in progress. I'm just pulling it, I'm moving it forward, I'm not pushing it, right? So it's a pull technique. Okay?
I wanted to ask this. You were saying that 3 columns, one is not started, then in progress, and third is done. Next is what you are planning to do, analysis, development, acceptance. But this talks about a little bit, I mean, I'm not able to map.
So this is a different kind. So typical Kanban board would be something like this. You have this board, right? These are the 3 columns. I'm sorry for my lines because I'm. So you would have not started here, in progress here, and done here. So under these, not started, you may probably divide it into 2 sections. One would say dev, another would say QA items, right? And similarly like this, this is another way of doing it. Another could be dev, QA. So right now, so under dev, creation of a framework is one task. Creation of test scenarios is one task. Creation of probably writing a code, let's assume. Then creation of a test data is one. So once I have say this, I'm working on it, I will move it here, right? Once I start creating my architecture framework, I'll move this here, right? Similarly, these are the different ways which we can do.
Yeah.
Right. Maybe you are if you're working track wise, right? QA and dev, generally, if you're not working in a pair way, right? If you want to maintain it in a different scenario, because this is how your client wants to see us from a reporting perspective, you might not need the second column. This column in that case would not be needed, because in that case, integration team would have a different task, Kanban board, a QA team would have a different, then it's just not started, in progress and done, would be there. You can have multiple boards as well, but if you want to showcase everything in a single board, or maybe if you have multiple teams, right, you have a project which has a support team as well, in that case it might become too chaotic for you, so you would want to track in a different Kanban boards.
Yeah, so surely. And if I want to just report on the QA thing, then that's also possible, right? Only QA on this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so this was just one example of how you can define your Kanban. So this was just one typical way. So like here you have feature story, right? So it will give you, if you're working on an iteration, like, I'll just pick up a pen. So here it might tell you which two stories you are working for, two iterations. Here you might have a risk section, right, which says this is the risk we see, and if it has been mitigated, you would want to probably cut it off, or maybe raise it off, or if it's getting overdue with the due dates, you can just start turning it red or something of that. This is how you want to visualize it. Okay.
There is also a RAG status wherein we write on schedule thing as green, and at risk thing as amber. So there is no conflict of that.
No. You can. So there could be. But in case if it's green, right, in a RAG status, you would always move it to done. You would not need the RAG status. If it's amber, that's in progress. It would be an in progress section. Yes, if your RAG status is defining how good it is. So for example, if I'm saying that red, for me the RAG status means red is it's the deadline has gone, so I expected it to be 2 hours, but it took me four, it is taking me 4 hours for some particular task. If that's the case, probably you would want to have another sticky notes, like, or maybe some color coding, or maybe some star, or some different kind of a, and you would want to define a legend. Like here we had stars, orange and green. So if you see, look at the legend below, it says orange one, the amber one is a defect, right? The pink one is blocked. Or if there is a person drawn out, it's again completely on your creativity.
Oh, I got the idea, but yeah.
Nice. Okay. So yesterday we also talked. Yeah.
Yeah, in Kanban. We have the backlog, right? And that backlog
not
is
started backlog.
Okay, so the first column says the next, I mean the task to be taken next, that's the backlog,
yes,
right?
Yes,
or
yes.
Backlog is different?
Yeah. No. So see, when you will start your iteration or your project, and if in particular iteration you are having 10 requirements, right? So all the 10 requirements would be in your not started. Once you start working, there could be a case where two of them are in done, one of them is in progress, and rest 7 of are in not started. The total count still remains the 10, but the basic backlog started from not started column.
Yeah, okay. So this backlog is for the particular iteration, not the whole product backlog.
No, it is. It would be convenient if you do it iteration wise. Otherwise, if you're doing it for a complete project, but if projects are real small ones, then it might make sense. But having it for the complete project would be really messy. I would not recommend going for that approach.
Okay.
So yesterday we were talking to work in progress limits as well. Where I mentioned that work in progress limit is a limit. If we reach that, we will not work beyond. Right. So here this picture says if my work in progress limit is 3. So in the case if my in progress field, in the in progress column, there are more than three tasks, I'll stop picking up any new task. I'll make sure that offer these 4 tasks or maybe 5 tasks completed, and then I pick any additional work. Because if there are more than 3 tasks in your in progress field, for me it's a clear indication that there are certain things which are going slow, or there are certain impediments which I need to work with my team to resolve.
Makes sense.
Right? So there could be a scenario, okay, I got stuck, one, okay, oh, this is not happening, let me park it in progress and I'll pick second, third, fourth. There could be risks or there could be challenges we are not able to proceed ahead. But then if you don't have a limit, there could be a stage where everything is in progress and nothing isn't done. Right? So you need to have that limit defined.
So this work in progress limit is different for every project and the team size, right?
You're right. Depending upon how complex your project is.